task at hand today is to change the hydraulic oil. So of course I've got the seat out of it, and as you can see, but down there somewhere, actually not a bad good shot, but right there, that big round thing is not the alternator, but the other thing, I believe that is the oil filter for the hydraulic system. We've had quite a leak here. Got some hoses and stuff like that that are leaking. So fluid's probably low for sure. So let's change the filter and top the oil up. And like I said, this thing's gonna have to be completely torn down, and we'll do that in the off season and get it all painted up and ready to go. But rusty manual, it looks like these are the, remove these plugs and fill it up until oil comes out. You can drain it back here, which we're not gonna drain it intentionally. That is. All right, let's clean this mess up here and see if we can't get to that filter. Okay, so of course we don't have the right tools. I guess the right tool is really whatever works to get it done. But I'm sure there's a wrench or something for that. Closer evaluation here. Looks like that whole piece comes off. Probably right there. Let's slide underneath so we can get it from the bottom. Turn. I didn't expect that. Yeah, it's like the whole thing's trying to turn. Do one at a time, I guess. Right on my light, of course. Next to be on the camera. the metal. No, this is supposed to be preventative maintenance, not maintenance. Grab it with this. That's all metal flake, man. This might have been one of them things like turn the radio up kind of things. You know what tool I have? It's never worked. But might work here. You guys remember these? As seen on TV. The Craftsman strap wrench. I got this thing for Christmas one year from Mom. Oh, I saw this on TV. Has never worked once. Watch it work now. I'm bringing back the strap wrench. Look at that. Look at that. What's going on? Why is that not turning with that? What is... As you can tell, I've never done this before. Why wasn't that... Is that? Feeling I'm gonna learn something. Strappy, do your thing. Put a little bit of oil on it, do that. All right. Possible just stuck on the O-ring? It's a mess. No. Can you see that? Please tell me you can't see that. It looks like my lucky streak continues.
Look at that. That is not supposed to be there. What is that?
He's crying about it. They drove it in here. The hydraulics just worked. That is a gasket material. What is that doing inside the oil filter? What? Gosh, it's getting even worse. What the hell is that? That's not supposed to be there. That looks important. Is it too late to put it together and sell it? The O-ring that it was stuck on there, which wasn't not in the filter box. What the hell? How did all that get in there? How does something like that run and drive, no problems. Filter's doing his job. I wonder if it was a previous repair. Somebody didn't clean the gaskets out. No way. Let's go put it in. Most of the time when you do a filter, you get a new, especially cartridge style, you get new O-rings. Lubricate O-rings. Especially when they're 50 years old. Torque that to 20 foot-pounds. All right. Let's fill it up with oil. All right. So according to Bobcat, that manual I have in there, you fill it here until it runs out of here. Thank you.
Sounds like we're dripping.
All right, so that just that simple. Let's hope that the filter did its job and it caught all that crap and it's not something that's falling apart. If it is, that's pretty shoddy workmanship by the dealer. It also goes to show that just because the dealer does it, doesn't mean that it's gonna be perfect. I've worked in a few dealerships, so. I've seen some of the monkeys, but not all of them. All those guys are really top of their game, but whoever did this job, if that was what happened, which almost has to be, how could gasket material get inside the hydraulic system other than, it's almost, yeah. So anyway, we'll find out. See ya.